presenter, who is also the co-organiser. We're a bit short of presenters this evening. You can only assume it's the audience. Welcome, welcome. It's a balloon game later on the major one. So, yes, I'm going to hand you over to... I'm Ivor Tipchap, by the way, the other co-organiser. And Richard is going to kick off our presentations. Richard.
Thank you. It's Mickey, by the way, because nobody will ever get that right. It's Mickey. I'm going to talk to you tonight about professional Northerners. As you may have spotted, I am a Northerner. It's an interesting thing for me because it's just what I do. I'm really, really Northern. People at my work just pick on me because I'm really Northern, but I don't give a toss. But so we'll start off. Where is the North? So it's not here. This is somewhere like off of Gandish, East Midlands. I don't know what really that is, but it's definitely not the North. For if you're from London, you probably think that is. Anyone from London? No, I'm caught. where is it? It's not here either. It's not. The answer's the northeast, but to me that's a different planet. People walking around with no shirts on. I've been up there to football games in the winter in November, and there's people there with no shirts on a football test. It's just wrong. They're really weird kind of biking stuff. Here's Yorkshire. This is the north. It's not this other side. It's not northwest because that's kind of Manchester, and that's again another place. And Liverpool again. It's another. Might as well be another planet. It's another nation. It's not really Northerners as far as I'm concerned. So what is professional Northerner? Well, he's not this fella. He's some sort of slow rangery guy from Kensington or something. He's not even wearing his jumper properly. And he's smiling. He's not even got cooking teeth, for Christ's sake. So what makes a professional Northerner? Well, for me, it's kind of an attitude. We like what we're saying. We say we're good, we're right, goes the phrase. It's just something that's India. There are several parts of making a professional Northerner. For the obvious, they're generally miserable, really, really miserable. Independent, we don't like to do what other people do. And we're kind of articulate in a rough roundabout way. We kind of just really wedge it in and it gets across that way. We're very argumentative, pretty political, artistic, and we'll come on to that. And this is the killer. They're all male. I don't think they're any professional Northerners who are women, really. That's probably because they don't really give a toss. They don't really want a professional Northerners. So, who are my partners? We've got a good old list here. We'll go through and knock them all off, and maybe we'll find out who's my professional Northerner. I'm sure you'll completely disagree with me at some point or another. So, who's our first candidate? It's Jimmy Savile. Now, he's definitely a Northerner. I live around here, and I see him tossing around the park every now and again. But he's, I don't know, when I was a kid, he was from Leeds. He's more sort of southern and BBC TV centre and running around and saving kids. Brian Blessed, not many people will know, but he is from Yorkshire. Absolutely, no, he's from Yorkshire, did you? He kind of hides it. Really, I really wish he was proud of it, more proud of it, but he hides it with his really theatrical voice. This is Marky Smith, for anyone who's not aware. He's miserable as hell, so he definitely qualifies. He's pretty articulate, he shouts a lot, he's argumentative, but he's from Manchester. So, unfortunately, don't quite do it. Again, Morrissey, professional Northern, he writes songs about the North, he's bloody miserable as hell. Again, he's articulate, he's fancy, but with all the flowers and things and waving arms, which I love. I'm a really big fan of Morrissey, but again, it's that Manchester thing, and he doesn't quite do it, not properly. Hockney is a Bradford lad, very, very Yorkshire, very Northern, but he spent a hell of a lot of time in America painting swimming pools and hanging out in California. He comes back and he's invested back in Yorkshire, but again, he's not really my professional Northern. Again, great Yorkshireman, writes about the district and the area, but he spent a lot of time in London with the footlights crowd. I don't know, he seems to be more a part-time Northerner, not really cutting mustard for me. This is Paul Heaton, for anyone who doesn't know. Paul Heaton's from Hull, so unfortunately I count him straight out. however, he's a Sheffield United fan, I'm from Sheffield, so that's good for me. He gave me a lot of my political learnings when I was a kid walking around the road and listening to his records. Sean Bean, one for the ladies. Now, Sean's from Sheffield, and he's definitely Northern. But he's a bit of a mentor Northerner for me. Oh, two things, and if you're a bit rough and manly in something, with a bit of a thick accent, you can get Sean, but he's not really here. Now Jarvis, again from Sheffield, he's a really good Northern as far as I'm concerned. He's articulate, everyone loves Jarvis. But again, not much of a Northern. He doesn't spend that much time in his native Sheffield, that much in Yorkshire, a lot downtown time in the south, and man in London. This is my professional Northerner. This is Brian Glover.
Yay!
Teddy Teaman. He was the football instructor in Kent. He wrote plays. He was in 1001 different character actor pieces in different sitcoms. He was even in, he was in Porridge, I don't really know he was in Porridge. And look at that. To play his strengths in this game, my strengths is that I've both had a rough looking in the ocean. And how much more proud and more professional than Kenny Hare than Brian Glover. Thank you.